Let us focus our hearts and minds as we listen to our gathering music. Good morning. Welcome everyone to worship this morning. Today is the sixth Sunday after Pentecost. And since the middle of June, we have been focusing on the theme of discipleship. That is, what does it mean to follow Jesus, to be a student of Jesus in our day and age? And so we've been focusing on that in our sermons and through the gospel readings. And this morning in our gospel reading, we encounter a bit of a conundrum or a paradox of sorts. It's the familiar verses where Jesus invites us, "Come to me, all you who are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest." Then Jesus talks about taking on his yoke and his burden upon ourselves. So the question is, how can yokes and burdens be easy and light? Well, we'll think about that in our sermon this morning. Our service continues with our gathering song, Glory and Praise to Our God, and let us stand as we are able. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Let us pray. You are great, O God, greatly to be praised. You have made us for yourself, and our hearts are restless until they rest in you. Grant that we may believe in you, call upon you, know you, and serve you. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
You may be seated.
Amen, Jim and Robert. Reading from the prophet Zechariah. Rejoice greatly, O daughter Zion. Shout aloud, O daughter Jerusalem. Lo, your king comes to you. Triumphant and victorious is he, humble and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. He will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the war horse from Jerusalem. And the battle bow shall be cut off, and he shall command peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, from the river to the ends of the earth. As for you also, because of the blood of my covenant with you, I will set your prisoners free from the waterless pit. Return to your stronghold, O prisoners of hope. Today I declare that I will restore to you double. We will read the psalm responsively with sung responses. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love.
Lord, you are good to all, and your compassion is over all your works.
All your works shall praise you, O Lord, and your faithful ones shall bless you.
They shall tell of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your power.
Then all people will know of your power and the glorious splendor of your kingdom.
Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Your dominion endures throughout all ages.
You, Lord, are faithful in all your words and loving in all your works.
The Lord upholds all those who fall and lifts up those who are downcast.
Today's second reading is found in St. Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 7. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing that I hate. Now, if I do not do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. But in fact, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now, if I do what I do not want, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do what is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self, but I see in my members another law at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us stand for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 11th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus spoke to the crowd, saying, "To what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another, 'We played the flute for you, and you did not dance. We wailed, and you did not mourn.' For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, 'He has a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, 'Look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds." At that time, Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Let us pray. Dear God, take our hands and use them. Take our feet and move them. Take our hearts and set them on fire. In your name we pray. Amen. A preacher and a teacher of ethics once observed that preachers up through the 19th century often attempted to lure people to Jesus by claiming Jesus was reasonable. If you want your life to make more sense, well, become a Christian. Beginning sometime in the last century, however, preachers stopped claiming that Jesus was reasonable and began claiming that Jesus was useful. Come to Jesus, and he'll fix whatever is wrong with your life. Jesus is useful in getting what you want. Well, it'd be awfully easy to hear today's gospel in that way. For what greater need do we have these days than the need for rest and comfort? Jesus says that if we come to him when we're weary and we're carrying heavy burdens, he will give us rest. If we take his yoke upon us and learn from him, we'll find him to be gentle and humble in heart, and we will find rest. Rest all the way down to our souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. However, let's be honest here. A burden, even though it may be light, is still a burden. A yoke is that implement that holds livestock in a harness so they can drag a plow through the dirt without departing from the straight and narrow. This is what Jesus calls comfort. I also note that Jesus says, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. In the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus is a master teacher, and Jesus has done some impressive teaching so far. His famous Sermon on the Mount, chapters 5, 6, and 7, and his instructions to the disciples before he sent them out to preach and teach and heal, those passages that we have been looking at over the last few Sundays. And one reason his teaching is so demanding is that it's not simply imparting new information to us, but it's also commanding us, inviting us, really, to a challenging new way of life. Jesus begins today's gospel, his gospel reading, lamenting that many criticize rather than follow him. Jesus invites them to a dance, but they refuse to dance in the way that Jesus wants them to. Jesus's teaching is demanding because he doesn't simply put out some interesting ideas, but he embodies his teaching. The teacher becomes the very content of his teaching. So let's be honest. Jesus' teaching can be tough. And yet he makes this astounding claim that his burden is light and his yoke is a blessing. How can he say that? Well, for one thing, we have to remember that the teacher is, in fact, Jesus. That means that not only does he teach wisdom with divine authority, but he's also describing actual reality, the way the world is, in fact, put together. Jesus is a window into the way things really are. The world was really put together with love and mercy at its core. Jesus invites us to the dance, to move with the universe, to get in step with the way, by God's grace, the world is now moving. But it's a dance that doesn't come naturally to us. It's a view of reality that we mostly aren't born with. Forgiveness and compassion for those in need. Loving our enemies. None of this comes naturally. We have to learn it. We must take this burden, which is ultimately a blessing, upon ourselves. We must bend ourselves toward this very different way of looking at the world, this very different way of being in the world. And thus Jesus makes this astounding claim that this burden is a blessing. To have the yoke of love around our necks keeps us moving in the right direction, moving together toward that loving place to which God is drawing all of us. Jesus begins today's gospel by complaining that people just won't loosen up. They won't join the party. They won't get in step with the dance. Well, we know how it is when we're learning to dance, right? We have to count out each step. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, or whatever it is. You have to think about what you're doing, making sure your feet are in the right place at the right time. But soon, you begin to dance. The rhythm of the music becomes part of you, and you realize you're overcome by the music. You're not thinking about dancing anymore. You're dancing. What was a challenging new task to be learned becomes part of you. Welcome to the dance we call salvation. Salvation in Jesus Christ. Amen. May the peace of God, which passes all human understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Sing of God, Lord, who sings.
And now let us confess our faith using the affirmation of faith printed in the bulletin. We believe in relationships. We believe in asking hard questions, in showing up for one another, and in sitting together through the pain. We believe in listening with grace, learning with curiosity, and apologizing with sincerity. We believe in asking for help, saying what we need, and trusting that no degree of vulnerability could strip us of God's love. We believe in trying our best and offering grace when our best is not enough. And we believe that God is in all relationships, modeling for us the value of community through the relationships of the Trinity. So we love today, and we strive to love even more tomorrow. Let it be so. Amen.
Let us pray. Confident that God receives our joys and concerns, let us offer our prayers for the church, those in need, and all of creation. God of the covenant, you call ministers to proclaim your gospel of grace throughout the world. Inspire pastors, deacons, church musicians, and all ministers of your word as they carry out your work. God, in your mercy, we bring our prayer to you. God of all creation, you reveal your goodness through all you have made, rivers and seas, plants and animals, and endangered species. Prosper the work of conservation organizations, botanical gardens, zoos, and wildlife sanctuaries. God, in your mercy, we bring our prayer to you. God of the nations, you desire that all of the peoples of the world live in peace. Guide government leaders at all levels, national, state, province, and local, to work for justice, mercy, and reconciliation. God, in your mercy, we bring our prayer to you. God of compassion, you bring healing to those who are sick, consolation to those who are grieving, and well-being to those who are distraught. Send skilled caregivers to all in need, especially Rich Myrie, Cornell Church, Ted Peters, Anagret, Rose, Marie, and all those we name before you or hold silently in our hearts. Make your presence known among all who suffer. God, in your mercy,
we bring our prayer to you.
God of promise, you renew the lives of those celebrating their baptismal anniversaries, especially Hannah Gable, Chloe Jacobs, and Barbara Bischoff. Bless their lives and stir in their hearts passion for the ministry to which you have called them. God, in your mercy,
we bring our prayer to you.
Into your hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, in the name of the one who reconciled all creation to himself, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Let us stand as you are able. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Share that peace with one another.
Peace. Peace, everyone, this morning. Peace.
Zoom. Peace.
Peace.
You may be seated. Just a few announcements before we continue. First of all, I'd like to thank Jim and Robert for that special music. Thank you. Thank you, Jim. And also Dawn, thank you for your playing this morning as well. Also, just a few announcements, a number of social action opportunities for us to serve in the community is on the back of the bulletin. And also the education series from Jesus to Christ, the First Christians, continues this Thursday at Shepherd of the Hills. We've had two sessions and we have two more. Even if you've missed the first two, please come to the last two. It's a wonderful time of fellowship, learning about our faith and discussing our faith together. And you can see the details in the bulletin.
So springboarding on Pastor Tom's, my yoke is heavy and my burden is light. There's an opportunity, you know, I take anything I can. I've been helping with the Jonathan's Place meal program. Last week was a holiday, so I'm going to repeat a little bit. If you were here, we dig it in again. Anyway, we are now providing all of the food from our own kitchen here at Marin Lutheran. I almost said my previous church there. So it's going to be the last Wednesday of every month. And we need three more people plus myself to help prepare the major portion of the meal. All the ingredients, what we need, are still posted outside. And one of the dishes this month is fresh vegetables. So if you have a garden at home, we need zucchini, tomatoes, and corn. So if you're growing a garden, want to donate some, that's great. The other thing is, if you have high school students, 16 and older, we can, and they need their community service hours for graduation. I think that's still a thing in Marin. They can come and we can help them with getting some of their hours. So the meal prep is 10 to 12 on the fourth Wednesday, which I believe is the 26th of July. So thank you very much and ask me questions if you have them.
Let us prepare for Holy Communion.
People and to the feast, all are invited the grace.
Let us stand. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. I invite those at home to raise your piece of bread. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." For those at home, I invite you to eat of the bread of life. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For those at home, I invite you to drink of the cup of salvation. Jesus, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. Here at Marin Lutheran Church, everyone is invited to come forward for Holy Communion. The usher will invite you to come up the center aisle, where you may kneel at the altar rail, and you'll receive a small piece of bread, and then a tray of small cups will come by filled with wine or grape juice. The grape juice is lighter in color. Each and every one of us is invited to this table. Come and know Christ, broken and poured out for you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let us stand. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen.
Let us pray. We thank you, generous God, for the refreshment we have received at your banquet table. Send us now to spread your generosity into all the world through the one who is our dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
People of faith, may God grant you the wisdom to listen, the strength to ask for help, the resiliency to choose love, and the courage to be a disciple of Jesus. Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, bless you now and forever. Amen.
Go out into the community with a daring and tender love. The world is waiting. Thanks be to God.